Hello and welcome to this tutorial on rotating a game object with mouse drag relative to screen width. What I mean by that is, for a game object to rotate around the target axis for one loop, the player should drag the mouse from one side to other side in x-axis on screen. Since one loop is 360 degrees, we will be applying the ratio of mouse drag to screen width to 360 degrees. The models used in this project is from Canny's Spreadsheet Asset Pack, which is linked in the down below. And hey, this is a 3D project, but I believe you will be able to apply this approach to a 2D settings as well. Here with a mouse drag in x-axis, the steering wheel starts to rotate proportionally to mouse distance. I had added a sphere as a knob, so when I move the mouse fast, we can still see it makes only one loop. Here, from one side to another, one loop. From middle to one side, half a loop. When the mouse is released, the rotation stops where it is currently. With new mouse drag, it starts rotating with current orientation, and that is how you can use this behavior. Now let's look at the script. We have three variables. Scene width holds the scene width value. This is the value we map the mouse drag. And the other two holds the initial states. Press point, initial position for mouse, and start rotation, initial rotation of the object. We get the scene width at the start. But if you were to proportionalize the movement with some dynamic width, you can set this width when the target width changes or on mouse press. Now that we have our starting point, let's move on to the rotation part. When left mouse button pressed down, we store initial position of the mouse as the current mouse position and the initial rotation of the game object from its transfer. After that, when mouse is continued to press down, we start the rotation. First step, calculate the movement distance in mouse position in x-axis, which is a very long variable name, current distance between mouse positions. This is the value to calculate the ratio between scene width and 360 degrees rotation. To rotate the game object, we will first calculate rotation in Euler angles, then translate this value to quaternion using quaternion Euler function. The rotation is applied to the game object using quaternion arithmetic. In quaternion arithmetic, to rotate a quaternion with another quaternion, you need to multiply them. This way, we will be able to rotate only the initial rotation by the ratio of mouse drag to 360 degrees. By applying this rotation to start rotation, we confirm there will be only maximum 360 degrees rotation with one mouse drag. And how we calculate this rotation is, first we need the rotation axis of the game object, which is that axis in this case. If you need other axis rotations, then change the vector 3 forward with that axis's positive representation, vector 3 right for x-axis and vector 3 up for y-axis. We can write new vector 3, 0, 0, something, but this way it will be easier to change the axes and more readable. Now we are at the proportionalizing part. By dividing the current distance between mouse positions to scene width, we find the mouse movement ratio to scene width. By applying this ratio to 360 degrees, we get the target rotation with mouse drag. Then we transform this Euler degree rotation to a quaternion and apply it to the start rotation. With each mouse change, we apply rotation. While you're at it, you can limit your rotation to 180 degrees or 90 degrees for one scene width mouse drag, if you would like. Just change the target number with what degree you want to limit the rotation. And where this comes from? Last week, I had participated in a game jam, and steering a ship with a steer wheel was one of the prototypes of mine, which was discontinued during the jam. But I liked the output of the implementation and thought of starting a small series revolving around similar mechanics. Hopefully, something will be helpful for your projects. With that, this is the end of this tutorial. If there was a point not clear, please let me know in the comments below. And if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe for future videos. I believe I will be continuing with object rotations with mouse drag for some time. And I hope to see you in the next explorations. And bye-bye!